See there? That's the door we need to reach. And those annoying prefects would love nothing more than to rat on us to Scribner. So don't let them see us. Understood?
I can be sneaky. Let's go.
Hold on now. There's a spell you should know. The disillusionment charm. Good for getting places you're not supposed to be. Cast it and you'll appear as little more than a trick of the light, just as long as you keep your distance and stay quiet.
You mean I'll actually be able to turn invisible?
Something like that. It's not as foolproof as a cloak, but those are expensive. And spells are free. Give it a try. Still here. Quick, behind the bookcase.
Damn. You told me the librarian would be gone by now.
I said usually, but it'll still be all right. Do you see her desk behind me? The key is in the drawer of that desk. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'll create a distraction to draw her away. You focus on getting the key. I'll meet you outside of the restricted section.
Wait, why do we need a key? Isn't there a spell for this?
Alohomora. That's how I always used to get in. But the librarian twigged that I knew the spell and cast an anti-Alohomora charm on the lock. So now it's just this key. But don't worry. I said I'd get you in, and I always keep my word. Trust me.
Peeves? Goodness gracious.
Oh, that one's charmed to look more useful than it is. It's fooled me twice. Never judge a tome by its cover, I say. Ghost, don't let her see you.
Should be in the floor now.
No need for us to be skulking about.
So what is it you've been looking for?
I'm looking for a cure to help my twin sister, Anne, so that she can return to Hogwarts.
Revelio!
Because Merlin knows everyone else is leaving.
Why do you think you'll find a cure in the restricted section? Does the Hogwarts matron have nothing that can help Anne?
No! We've tried everyone from Nurse Blaney to St. Mungo's. But I can research on my own. No need to concern yourself with that right now. Let's focus on what you're after. Which is what, precisely?
I'll know it when I see it.
You're being awfully cryptic.
Levioso.
Who have we here? Sebastian Solo and his new little friend. Out exploring where they shouldn't be. Naughty, naughty. You'll get caughty.
Peeves, don't you...
I'm going to tell.
Oh, blasted Peeves. I've got to stop him or at least get to the librarian with a good excuse for all of this.
Wait, I don't want you getting into trouble for me.
I have a way with the faculty when it comes to disciplinary matters. Besides, I like having friends who are in my debt. Now go. Good luck in your search. Now, where has that damned poltergeist got to?
I know just the spell to repair this armor.
Reparo!
Of course, traces of ancient magic. There must be more to this room.
That's it! Lumos.
Where might this lead?
Levioso.
Reparo.
Ah, I need to wake up that rune over there.
Accio. Leviosa. Leviosa.
Surprising. Guards at the ready.
Protego. Reparo. Levioso.
This must be the way forward, but to where? Nearly there. Best keep my wits about me.
Potato,
stupefy.
Levioso. Levioso. Protego. Levioso. Stupefy. Accio. Levioso. Accio.
It is a book after all.
You wanted to see me, Headmistress Fitzgerald, Professor Rackham.
Miss Isadora Morganach, welcome.
Professor Rookwood, Professor Bacall.
We understand that you are adjusting well to life at Hogwarts.
I am.
I am glad, especially in light of your unusual situation, starting as a fifth year.
As it happens, I was also admitted to Hogwarts as a fifth year. I've never heard of another like us.
Miss Morganach, when we spoke yesterday after class, you asked about the beautiful swirls you saw years ago when we visited your hamlet.
I recognized you all immediately. I cannot thank you enough for what you did.
We were glad to help.
And yes, I did see swirls of magic everywhere that day. My father insists it was my imagination running wild, but it was certainly real to me.
It was not your imagination.
Percival, Professor Rackham can see them too. But we have never known of another who could.
I don't understand. What are they?
The whispers or traces that appear when a particular form of ancient magic is wielded.
Ancient magic?
Few are capable of wielding it. Hogwarts itself is a stronghold of ancient magic.
So if I can see traces of ancient magic, does that mean I can wield it too?
With the proper training.
But let us not get ahead of ourselves, Miss Morganach.
Before I can train you to wield such magic, you must first master all that Hogwarts has to offer.
A magic this powerful can do great harm in the wrong hands. It must be wielded by a select few. Such, we ask that you not speak to anyone about what we have discussed here today.
sneaking in the restricted section again! I had thought we were through with this mischief. Clearly, detentions are insufficient. I'm afraid I must take this to the headmaster.
But that being said, Peeves informs me that you didn't come alone tonight. If someone has coerced you, I would have you tell me. You're a bright boy. Don't waste this.
There was nobody else. I came alone.
Oh, Sebastian. What will your uncle say?
Revelio.
Another adventure, are we?
You cannot be serious. Goblins working with Rookwood makes no sense.
It is rather unorthodox, to say the least.
Unorthodox? It's inconceivable. It's... Ah, Fig. You have a visitor. I'll see what I can find out.
Sir, I was able to search the restricted section while you were with Professor Black. It was a book we were after.
What? That's... Wait. You accessed the restricted section? But how? Thinking on it, perhaps it's best you spare me the details.
Fair enough. In fact, the book was below the restricted section, as it appeared on the map.
I want to hear everything. First, let's have a look. Dear, some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time. I wonder why it was here, below Hogwarts.
I think I know, sir. I saw two more memories where I found the book.
Another pensive. Godric's heart.
The man we saw before, Percival Rackham, was a professor here. The first memory showed him and three other professors using ancient magic to restore a hamlet from a drought.
Miriam was right. And the second memory?
They were talking to a student who started as a fifth year, like I did. She could see traces of magic too.
Why those memories? Perhaps this book will explain. I'll have to take it with me to London. The headmaster has insisted that I speak directly to the minister about George's death.
What will you tell them about Mr. Osric's death?
I don't know how much I dare say. George tried to convince the ministry about Ranrock, but to no avail. My instinct is to follow the path we are on for the moment and keep the details to ourselves until we know more.
I understand. I'll see what I can learn about the missing pages while you're gone.
Good. Don't neglect your studies. Your wand work is improving by the day. But you'll want to pay attention in herbology and potions. There's more to magic than spellcasting.
Plenty to keep me occupied while you're gone.
You've done exceptionally well. I look forward to seeing all that you've accomplished when I return. Oh, and don't neglect your friends. You may be surprised by how much you can learn from them as well.
Revelio. Levioso. Accio.
It's time to prove your dueling mettle and see if we've a new school champion. Meet me at the usual place for the final round of crossed wands. Also, the training dummy is still available.
Lumos.
In Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle.
Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Rumor has it there's an abandoned manor.
Revelio.
I'd make a fine keeper with a bit more practice.
Is she growing pungous onion again?
Good morning, Professor Garlic. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Ah, hello. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. It is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio! Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug. Should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone! Now, for our next task, we'll be planting dittany at our potting tables. You can all...
I wonder if hippogriffs like not grass.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the magic neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement.
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganmel potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class. Done. fun. Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage. You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
The best time to plant a seed is last season. The second best time is now.
Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh.
Here we are. Home of the Chinese chompy. Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest. Look at that! They'll chomp on anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that just have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
I suppose they could prove useful outside of the greenhouse. Nothing wrong with a bit of backup, even if it is from a cabbage.
It's chaos out there. Trolls in Hogsmeade and such. You can't be above throwing a cruciferous vegetable if necessary. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too,
ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
And with that helpful reminder as to why... Wear our drag. I shall end our lesson here. Terribly sorry, Mr. Clopton.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Hope those mandrakes are really relishing their new pots. Only cost me my damned hearing.
To make anything grow, we must first understand it. That goes for plants as well as friendships. Kindness and concern are as necessary in the greenhouse as in the great hall.
Sharp's desk. I bet he knows more than he's letting on about the Goblin Rebellion.
Rebellion.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wiganweld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the...
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
He did say that. He wants me to get more ingredients to brew another potion.
Brilliant! You, my friend, have been presented with an extraordinary opportunity. You remember me, don't you? Gareth Weasley.
Ah, yes. We met in the common room.
Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single Fooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'll get you the Fooper feather, as long as you're certain Sharp won't miss it.
I assure you he won't. Fooper feathers aren't that valuable. Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
Remember. Keep your potion stations organized and free of clutter.
Here's the Fooper feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you. This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Edurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Should you chop the didney or crush it? The wrong answer could result in the unfortunate loss of your eyebrows.
And now we add the mallow sweet, and that's odd. What's happening?
My wiggle.
Wait, it's not supposed to. Ah!
Get it!
Again!
Oh!
Dragon time!
What happened?
Don't fret if you run out of ingredients. I simply grow them.
What now, Mr. Weasley?
Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor. Again, Mr. Weasley did not do this on his own. His accomplice will answer to me as well.
I brewed an Adura's potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm not sure what you're talking about, Professor.
You will not earn favor with me by failing to take responsibility for your actions. I suggest you heed my warning. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical, given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day. Class is dismissed.
That was an interesting class.
Thanks to you. Wasn't precisely what I had in mind, but it was still brilliant. I appreciate your help. I hope Sharp wasn't too disagreeable when you handed in your potion. Heard him talking about taking responsibility.
Professor Sharp was annoyed, but we sorted it out. No harm.
Cheers to that. He probably had a good chuckle after we left. Sharp may seem gruff, but I'd bet a few galleons he blew up a potion or two in his day. Best be off. Next time we talk, I promise, fewer explosions.
Professor Sharp must have...
Ugh, my robes are going to reek from Gareth's inspiration. Now,
was it two pinches of Angelica?
Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Accio!
Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Levioso. Reparo. Lumos. Revelio.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of cross wands ready?
Big match today.
It all comes down to this. The moment that we find out if your training and dedication is enough to win it all. Ready for a shot at glory?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
Yes, Natty.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
Incendio.
Levioso! Incendio!
Levioso!
Protego!
Arrest momentum!
Incendio!
Levioso!
Accio! Incendio. Protego.
Descendo.
Fringa. And Protego.
Incendio. Accio. Levioso!
Pity more people can't watch the duels.
What a victory! You've won the tournament!
That was nothing. I'm just getting started.
If the best duelists in the school weren't enough competition, then perhaps you should consider transferring to Durmstrang. Now, to the victor goes the prize! And so it is my great honour to present you with this simple yet elegant token of supreme dueling accomplishment!
Thank you. It's been an honour.
You earned it! You are a duelist to be reckoned with! Now that we've definitively crowned the tournament winner, I suppose I should get back to my schoolwork. Wonder how my herbology plants are doing. I haven't tended them in ages.
Yes. Hello, Lucan. I'd like to practice with the training dummy.
Excellent idea. This time will be a bit more of a challenge. Ready?
That'd be brilliant.
Wonderful. I'll set things up. Remember to cast all the spell combinations before the dummy lands again. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know.
Incendio! Accio!
Incendio! Levioso!
That's it!
Incendio.
Nicely done.
Accio. Incendio. Levioso. Accio.
You'll get it.
Incendio.
Levioso.
Accio. Incendio.
Good one! Impressive wand work. I'd hate to face you in a duel.
Thanks, Lucan. You've been a great help.
I'll stop. Don't make me blush. Seriously, well done. Training dummies will think twice before challenging you again. Even though you won the tournament already, I'm glad to see you haven't stopped training. Stay sharp, my friend.
Lost to a new student? I didn't see that coming. Revelio. Revelio.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Natty. How are you?
I am well, thank you. I was there, and I saw what happened with Rookwood and Harlow at the Three Broomsticks. I have been worried about you.
I'm all right at the moment.
If you don't mind my asking, why were they looking for you?
I've never met Rookwood or Harlow. Perhaps they mistook me for another student.
A bit odd. The two of them pursuing a Hogwarts student so intently. But whatever the reason, you were clearly in danger. For now, it is safe to say that Rookwood and Harlow are a threat to both of us, to all of us. Which is why I wanted to speak to you. Everyone has been talking about you defending Hogsmeade from that troll attack. And I shall never forget watching Serona stand up to Rookwood and Harlow in the Three Broomsticks. Both of you have inspired me to take a stand of my own.
What sort of stand?
Men like Rookwood and Harlow are the reason my mother and I left Matibililand. I am not going to sit by and watch them destroy my new home.
Good. Rookwood and Harlow are a dangerous pair. And you should know that Rookwood is in league with Ranrok.
I had heard they were seen in Hogsmeade together. All the more reason they must be stopped. Rumor has it that Theophilus Harlow runs Rookwood's day-to-day operations. Taking him down would cripple Rookwood's entire enterprise.
That may be true, but shouldn't Officer Singer handle someone like Harlow?
I spoke with her. She was polite, but perhaps understandably would not discuss details with a student. I overheard some of Rookwood's lot talking about a massive poaching operation that Harlow is planning. I was thinking that we could investigate a bit, try to get the evidence that Officer Singer needs.
All right, but how?
I am going to watch and listen, find out precisely what Harlow is up to. I shall reach out when I know more. In the meantime, remember, I am here if you need me.
Thank you, Natty.
Be on your guard.
I beg your pardon! How dare you threaten me!
What's going on here?
But Mummy...
Archie, I don't have time to argue. I've told you repeatedly not to stray far from home. Especially when I'm inside...
I never thought Ramrock...
Pardon me, is everything all right?
Hardly. I've just lost my business and almost my life. You'd best look elsewhere for wares. I've nothing to sell now. I never thought it'd come to this. Be on your guard. Ramrock and his loyalists will spare no one.
They attacked you.
Oh, Ramrock has no patience for goblins who won't join him. While I too would like to see goblin kind treated by wizards as equals, bloodshed is not the answer. When I said as much, they turned on me, struck me till I nearly passed out. Took my carts, my belongings, even that which is most precious to me, my paintings.
Has Ranrock's lot ever attacked you like this before?
They've been taunting and threatening me for a while now. But they've always believed that violence is the only way to get what they want. Things have taken a much darker turn of late. Ramrock is getting more powerful, and his loyalists know it. They feel untouchable. Ramrock assumed that all goblins would agree to follow him, but he was wrong. Many of us would like a diplomatic end to the discord with wizardkind.
You mentioned that your paintings were taken. Are you a painter?
I am. It's my calling, though most would think it an unusual path for a goblin. Most of my family work in metal, or associated with Gringotts. I'd wager my finest brush that Ramrock's lot have no appreciation for any of my work, and it'll be tossed aside for kindling. Without my carts and my livelihood, who knows when I'll be able to paint again.
I'm sorry this happened to you. I shall certainly keep an eye out for your carts.
That is very kind of you, but I think they took them to their camp southwest of here, just past some ruins. Too dangerous to try and retrieve them. I did enchant the carts to return to me if I ever lost them, however. Slim though the chances may be, I'm holding out hope that some of what was taken is returned to me. It was nice meeting you. I wish it had been under better circumstances.
After what Ranrock did to that goblin banker at Gringotts, I shouldn't be surprised at what happened to Arn.
They must have come this way! Think!
I've no idea who it is you think I might have seen. I've been busy with my research. I do not have time to...
Victor Rookwood don't give a doxy's nip about your time. Oi! Speak of the devil! Mr. Rookwood would like a word with you.
Students, you can't be
serious. Enough out of you.
Leave her alone.
Stupid right!
You there! I see you!
Levioso! Incendio!
Stop that!
I'll watch the light go out of your eyes. You there! Stop! Hang on!
I'm not going anywhere with you. Incendio!
You take this student to my dead body! That's it! Redactor! Not so tough, then! You'll pay for that!
What on earth just happened? I've never been accosted in such a manner, and so close to Hogwarts.
Are you all right?
I am, thanks in no small part to your excellent defensive skills. Care to tell me why two Ashwinders were ready to dispatch me to get to you?
Ashwinders?
Victor Rookwood's thieves and extortionists, his little cronies. They seemed quite keen on you.
It's a long story, but thank you for your help.
Well, you've avoided them for the moment. Priya warned me things were getting dangerous. Best get moving on my research before they return.
You mentioned someone named Priya.
Yes, my wife. She's the one who piqued my interest in Merlin, gave me a book when we were students at Hogwarts. Typical hard-working Hufflepuff, brilliant potioner, has her own shop in Nocturne Alley. She's a travelling vendor. Here's what's going on in the Highlands before I do.
You're a researcher.
Nora Treadwell at your service. Historian and archaeologist specialising in Merlin's work and life.
I thought that Merlin and the tales about King Arthur's court were a myth.
Mere myth? You're lucky Sir Cadogan didn't hear you. Chatters on endlessly about his connection to Merlin from his portrait at Hogwarts. Merlin attended Hogwarts, you know, and I'm studying some curious fixtures he left here centuries ago.
Fixtures?
These vine-covered pillars, dozens of them all around the area. I've taken to calling them the Trials of Merlin. I believe he created them as a diversion for his fellow Slytherins. He was terribly fond of puzzles and enigmas.
I can see why you're so interested in Merlin. I'd be keen to know more about the trials.
Well then, I'll let you in on a little secret. No one has yet managed to figure out how they work. But I believe I have just unlocked a crucial clue. I suspect that mallow sweet is an important component in getting the trials to work.
Mallow sweet?
Versatile herb. Merlin repeatedly mentioned it in his writings. I had just arrived to test my theory when I was so rudely interrupted. You see, each swirl in Merlin's writing has a symbol in the centre. That started me thinking, what if...
The mallow sweet is meant to be placed at the centre of the symbols.
Precisely. Would you care to do the honours? We can see what comes of our little hypothesis. I brought a trunk chock full of mallow sweet with me. It's just over there by my tent.
This trunk?
Yes, take plenty.
Leviosa!
You already have some.
I have the mallow sweet.
Lovely. Now, notice the vines on these pillars here, as well as a stone swell on the ground. Each trial has these features. Place the mallow sweet on the swell, and we'll see what happens. My word! Did you see that? The vines disappeared!
What should I do now?
This is uncharted territory. I am curious about these pyres.
Levioso! Accio! Levioso! Incendio!
Merlin's beard!
The flames make the pyre sink.
I can hardly believe it.
I take it we can call that a success?
We can indeed. However, I now have even more questions. How does it work? I must review my notes. I may have missed something.
Are all of the trials like this one?
Oh, not precisely. Well, I think each has those telltale vines and the swirl on the ground. You should feel free to solve them as you come across them. I believe I have what I need to continue my research. My guess is that each will also require mallow sweet, which you can find in Hogsmeade should you need more. I really must be off. Such a pleasure to meet you. And do be careful out here. Now I've got what I needed, I shall return to the safety of my notes and books.
Might I beseech you for some assistance?
Hello, can I help you?
Oh, thank goodness. Yes, my name is Grace Pinch Smedley. Of the Bath Pinch Smedleys? I was hoping someone would come along soon. I was about to defy my father's wishes and would never have forgiven myself. You see, I need to retrieve something from the bottom of the lake. Might you be the one to help me?
Diving into the lake sounds like an adventure. Tell me more.
Splendid! Precisely the response I'd hoped for.
What do you need help retrieving?
Years ago, my grandfather, who fancied himself quite the astronomer, set sail from Hogsmeade Station for what was meant to be a quick stargazing cruise with my grandmother. They never returned.
I'm so sorry. What happened to them?
We can't be sure. We only know that neither they nor their boat made it back to shore. They were presumed drowned. Father was so distraught that he forbade our family from setting foot on or in the Black Lake ever again. A treasured family astrolabe vanished with them that night. If you could dive down and retrieve it, I may be able to bring my father some peace.
You seem to think I might have heard of the Bath Pinch Smedleys. Why would I know your family?
That's like asking why the sky is blue or grass is green. The Pinch Smedley name is synonymous with intellectual curiosity. We are known for our contributions to science and art. I'm surprised you haven't heard of us, frankly. But with all I plan to discover about the world around us, those that don't yet know the name certainly one day will.
What exactly is an astrolabe?
It's an astonishing ancient navigational tool, essentially a handheld model of the universe. It's mainly used for studying the stars, astronomical pursuits, but it has nearly 1,000 uses. Fascinating device. Sadly, I'd imagine it's rusted beyond repair now. Still, we'd love to have it returned to us. It would be like getting a bit of my grandparents back.
It sounds dangerous, especially for something of mere sentimental value.
I understand. But I'd be forever grateful. Of course, you may discover much more than the astrolabe. Anything else you found would be all yours. I've cross-referenced the vessel's last alleged location against the lake's topography, depth charts, and tide chart. My best guess is that it's just over there, about a furlong from the dock. It would be wonderful to have my grandfather's astrolabe back.
Sir Nicholas, our house ghost, is looking for you. You can find him near the great...
Grace, what was it you needed my help with?
I was hoping you could dive down and retrieve a treasured family astrolabe lost during a doomed stargazing cruise.
This must be where the Pinch Smedley family astrolabe is. should let Grace know that I found her family astrolabe.
Too terribly difficult.
Hello, Grace. I followed your bearings on a dive in the Black Lake.
Oh, how incredible! Did you find the astrolabe?
I did. I hope it makes your father happy.
It will. I can't wait to see his face. Thank you so much for doing this for me and for my family. You do well to keep an eye out for more spots to dive. A diver of your caliber is certain to find all sorts of things down there. Thank you again. And I do hope you keep diving. You certainly have a knack for finding treasure.
It's like a place right out of a storybook.
If you're here for my wares, I'm afraid I...
Hello, sir. What do you sell here?
Hello. I'm Jalal Sami, and this is my potion shop. I can answer any questions you have about the town.
Any whispers going about the town?
You may have noticed we have a bit of a rivalry with Upper Hogsfield. Not much to it, but we're still the better of the two Hogsfields. Better than most other places, too.
Can you tell me a bit about yourself?
Oh, let's see. Well, I am Lower Hogsfield's preeminent potioner. But I was once a lowly Hogwarts student like you. In fact, I'll give you the Hogwarts discount. It's the standard price. My prices are low enough already, you see.
What do you have for sale?
I sell only potions and their ingredients. If you can't fix it with a potion, then it's best left broken, I say. My ingredients are all local to this area, and my potions are brewed to keep you healthy and safe.
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today?
After what Ranrock did to that goblin banker at Gringotts, I shouldn't be surprised at what happened to Arn.
Revelio. Accio. Reparo.
Revenue.
If you're here for my wares, I'm afraid I still don't have my car.
Revelio. Incendio.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Levioso.
You there? Yes, you. I wonder if you might come with me from...
You want to see me, sir?
Yes, Sir Nicholas de Mimsey Porpington, at your service.
Nice to meet you, Sir Nicholas.
I know about the book you found and its missing pages. I may be able to help. Follow me, if you will. It's not too far.
Wait, how do you know about the book? And that it's missing pages?
Word gets around amongst the ghosts. You were spotted with Mr. Sallow in the restricted section. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me. This may be a leap, but I believe I know who ended up with those pages. I'd be happy to take you to him, if you'd be so kind as to perform a small favor for me along the way.
A small favor in exchange for getting those pages.
Yes, it's nothing really. I'd be grateful if you could simply go into the kitchen and procure a little rotten roast beef.
I beg your pardon. Roast beef. Rotten roast beef.
That is correct. Rotten roast beef. If one floats through it just right, one can almost taste it.
Ugh. I suppose I can do that. But why me?
It's simple, my young friend. My ghostly form cannot carry it. Now, if you'd be so kind as to collect the roast beef, I shall explain everything else in due course. Ah, here we are. Tickle the pear and head on in.
Did you say tickle the pear?
Yes, in the painting. I'll wait right here. Do try not to get in the way of the house elves. I'm already
imagining
the sweet aroma of rotten roast beef.
Never will understand
the
students.
What could they want?
Delicious food and would find themselves a bit peckish, likely.
Sir?
You know how hungry.
Ugh, there's a disgusting smell. I must be getting close.
Oh, a student? What a treat! What can Finky get for you? A pumpkin pasty? Perhaps some Welsh rabbit?
Sounds lovely, but what I really need is this rotten roast beef.
Ah, Nick sent you, didn't he? Please help yourself. Finky supposes Nick's tired of loitering about simply to experience the faintest memory of the taste of food.
Do you and the other house elves conjure the food served in the Great Hall?
Goodness, no. Not even house elves can conjure food out of thin air. Food is one of the five principal exceptions to Gamp's law of elemental transfiguration. We can, however, multiply it, transform it, and, of course, prepare it. Then we send it straight up to the Great Hall.
Are there any restrictions as to what you can make here?
Finky supposes not. However, Finky has had the best luck with the many recipes left by Helga Hufflepuff. Her quince pie has always been a favourite, but the newfangled Arbro Smokies are becoming popular as well.
Is it all right for students to wander into the kitchens?
Well, since you asked, students aren't supposed to be in the kitchens, but Finky doesn't mind. There's nothing that lifts Finky's spirits more than the company of students. We so rarely get visitors, and we have plenty of treats. Come back any time you please.
It was nice to meet you. Thank you for the beef.
Happy to help, and to meet you as well. Please give Nick Finky's regards.
There's nothing like a meal prepared by a house elf.
Ah, you're back. No trouble, I take it?
Not at all. Fienke sends her regards, along with the rotten roast beef.
Ah, glad to hear it. Kind elf, Fienke. Now, let's get that beef to Sir Patrick Delaney Podmore, and you'll be one step closer to finding those pages.
This is all rather cryptic, Sir Nicholas. What's going on?
Terribly sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. Sir Patrick organises the Headless Hunt, a group of headless ghosts who gather for various, headless activities.
Headless activities?
Yes, you'll see. Anyway, I don't know how, but a member of that hunt, Richard Jackdaw, had the pages when he was alive. My plan is to take the rotten roast beef to Sir Patrick so that he'll allow me, us, to engage with the hunt and speak to Jackdaw. Shall we?
I thought the rotten roast beef was for you.
It is, in a way. You see, I've been trying to gain access to the hunt for quite some time. Offering the beef to Patrick may help me in that regard. While, of course, also helping you.
What am I supposed to do when we meet the hunt?
Allow me to do the talking. They can be a rather supercilious lot. I'm certain they'll be welcoming to you, however, in no small part due to the rotten roast beef you will come bearing.
Is the headless hunt dangerous?
Oh, the headless hunt wouldn't hurt a fly, let alone a student. Just a group of fun-loving headless ghosts.
Very well. I'd like to meet Sir Patrick myself and see this headless hunt.
Ah, wonderful. You won't regret it. Do stay behind me. It's Sir Patrick we want.
Oi, Nesta, look who's here.
What have we told you, nearly headless Nick?
Hello, Sir Amzet. Do let us pass. We've brought a little something for Sir Patrick.
Probably come to try to beg his way in again.
Do they always talk to you like that?
Oh, all in good fun. Once Sir Patrick lets me join the headless hunt, I'll be right there with them. This offering is sure to win him over.
Don't forget why I'm here, sir.
Rest assured, you'll have your information from young Jackdaw in no time. Wherever he may be.
What I'd give for a flagon of mead or a nice leg of lamb right about now. Then this party would be complete.
How about the next best thing, Sir Patrick?
Ah, Sir Nicholas. And a student. Who let you in?
We brought you a gift.
This is all very suspicious. What do you really want? As if I need to ask.
It's Richard Jackdaw. Where can we find him? May we speak to him?
Jackdaw, eh? Why, here he is now. What a shame. Without his head. I bet you've always wondered what that's like, eh, Nick?
sir, you jest.
It's bound to be around here somewhere. Probably being used in a game. If you find it, I give you my permission to speak with him, my young mortal. It's the least I can do for you for bringing this putrescent gift home.
Sir, there's another matter I wish to discuss with you, if I may.
Tut-tut, Sir Nicholas. How many times do I have to tell you? Our entry requirements are quite clear.
But, sir, I...
We aren't the headless except for a little bit of tendon hunt, after all. Now, please, follow me and I shall help you find your way out.
Farewell, my young friend. Perhaps your luck with these chaps will be better than mine.
For games.
A map. It doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now.
You don't have a one.
Next to play our little game of hide-and-seek amongst the pumpkins.
Hello again. Can you help me?
Ah, Sir Nicholas's young friend. Has he abandoned you?
Not at all. I need to speak to Richard Jackdaw. Sir Patrick said his head might be around here somewhere.
Indeed it might be. It is a bit unorthodox to include a mortal, but if you do wish to speak with him... Oh, why not? You can speak with Jackdaw if you can find his head amongst these pumpkins. Not just once, but 5 times. Good old Dumfrey will move the head to a different spot each time you find it. Those are the rules. What say you?
If that's what I need to do to speak to Jackdaw, I'll do it.
Marvellous! Of course, a mortal holding a wand has an advantage over us ghosts. You can simply blast away to your heart's content. Remember, the game's not over until you find him 5 times. Begin! Cast away!
Discovered already? Looks like we need to find another pumpkin to hide in, eh, Jackdaw?
Whatever you say, Dumfrey, this is not my finest moment.
Well, good job, I suppose. But we're not through with you.
I'm glad I won't be the one to clean up this mess.
So you found us. Well, this ain't over yet.
Young Jackdaw's no match for you.
Who would have thought a mortal would...
Why did I come back here?
I've never seen it played like this.
For a mortal? Now, say what you need to say to old Jackdaw here, You've earned it.
Nicely done. But what's going on? You're not a member of the Headless Hunt.
No, I'm not. Sir Nicholas said you might know the location of some pages I'm looking for.
Merlin's beard. I know precisely the ones you mean. I pinched them from Peeves. How could I forget? The map on those pages led me to my demise. I was not ready for what awaited me in that cave. The pages are likely still mouldering away with my, remains. Quite a final adventure, I must confess.
The pages are why you lost your head, and I must visit a cave and search for your corpse.
Yes. You'd think a decapitated ghost would get used to the word corpse. Say, here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll show you where to go.
What will I find in the cave?
Aside from my mortal remains, if I remember correctly, some treasures, a magical bridge. But what kind of an adventure would it be if I spoiled the surprises for you?
Did someone in the cave cut off your head?
I was having a look around when I suddenly sensed a refreshing breeze. After which I felt, well, light-headed. That's all I remember. Hence, when you visit, be prepared. I can't tell you what for specifically, but you seem a perceptive sort. Beware a light breeze.
How is it possible to steal from Peeves, a poltergeist?
I didn't steal the pages from his ghostly form. I merely found them in his wake of destruction. He has a penchant for wrecking things. Books, bottles, suits of armor. Whatever's likely to cause the most chaos. I found them after he ran riot through the library. Doubt he even noticed they were gone.
I need those pages, so I suppose I'd better meet you. Thank you.
Not to worry. I'll just need to be reunited with my body first. But Dumfrey can handle that. See you at the forest's edge.
Seems a pleasant enough little place. After what Ranrok did to that goblin banker at Gringotts, I shouldn't be surprised at what happened to Arn. Past the ruins. I'm on the right track. An encampment. This must be it.
Whiskey over here.
Looks as if there's more than one way to enter.
Arn will regret not joining us. If he doesn't come round now, he'll be made even more of an example.
We should have killed that traitor, Arn, when we took his car.
Leviosa, Accio. Incendio.
Patrol.
How many of you are there?
One less human to worry about.
Protego! Levioso! Accio!
Easily divergent. Your spells glance off of me.
Why is it crap?
You are not heavily up there. Surely you can see that. Ready? Are you quite finished?
Levioso.
What an unfortunate disappointment!
You won't stop me.
Accio. Incendio.
Pity.
Fuck you!
Ranrok will lead us to victory!
Levioso! Incendio!
I won't rest until you're dead.
Levioso! Incendio! Accio!
No! That's
better than you. I've been fighting since before you were born.
I shall avenge your death. An utterly pitiful display. You're not even trying!
Levioso! No. Accio! No. Incendio! No. That was quite something. Now, to free Arn's cards. Incendio! Accio! Levioso! Protego! Accio! quite an enchantment. The carts were turning to Arn. Accio! Levioso! Accio! Incendio. Levioso. Revelio. Incendio. Reparo. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Incendio. Accio. so tricky after all, Merlin.
Revelio.
Handy resource indeed. You're
I wonder who lives here.
If you're here for my wares, I'm afraid I still...
On, I have good news. Your carts are on their way back.
I don't know what to say. Any hope I have of getting my belongings back was quickly fading. Ramrock's lot called me a fool for believing in the good in wizard kind. Thank you for proving them wrong.
I managed to free your carts fairly easily.
Oh, I'm glad you're all right. Oh, I can't wait to have my things back, especially my paints. You know, you've inspired me. I've been dealing with witches and wizards for years, and we've always got along just fine. Perhaps my next piece will be a tribute to all that is good between us.
What a nice idea, Ron. I wish you luck with it.
I can't wait to get started. Thank you again for all you've done. All the best to you.
Revelio.
Why don't you have a little peruse? Appreciate you stopping by. Be sure to visit me again, won't you?
Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? I'll have no trouble selling this. Thank you. I hope to see you again sometime.
Off on another adventure, are we?
I can't go up there. Seems that's off limits to me.
What are you up to now?
Thank you.
Professor, I wondered...
To take care of everything I...
Professor, I completed all of your most recent assignments.
Well done. Then you're ready to learn Expelliarmus. Pay close attention. The disarming charm may often be all you need to defeat the most powerful dark witches and wizards you might encounter. Spellcasting requires a focused mind and a steady wand. Good work. The dummy is here if you wish to stay in practice.
Expelliarmus!
You seem to have the right end of the stick, but keep practicing. Expelliarmus
Lumos.
May save your
Incendio.
Life.
Incendio! Expelliarmus! Accio! Incendio! Expelliarmus!
Still at it, I see.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio!
Says it's good to get out of the house.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Levioso! Accio! Incendio! Accio!
yourself.
Accio! Incendio!
You've made a mistake!
Kafringa!
Potato!
Stop that!
Huh? You release Treadwell!
Potato! You disappoint me! Reducto!
Leviosa!
You're not going to like this.
Instead,
I can't roll you away out of this.
Reducto!
Leviosa!
Am I some?
Expelliarmus! Leviosa!
Child!
Ha! Nice try!
What have you done?
Is that the Reducto?
Accio!
Reducto!
Reducto!
Expelliarmus!
Clumsy little fool! You're a bit shoddy with your skills, aren't you, sweetheart?
Leviosa.
Nice try.
Expelliarmus. Revelio.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. Just like a Gryffindor to brave the Forbidden Forest in pursuit of adventure.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin. Or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the birdbath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks. A stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu. Is that Latin? Or Greek?
Nothing to do now but keep going.
Revelio.
The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word. Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Incendio.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. Attack! I don't think you know.
Incendio.
You won't get up.
Is that the best you can do?
Expelliarmus. No risk those loyalists will report back to Renrock now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me. I wonder how big this place is.
Accio! Accio!
Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this. touch those. Ugh. Accio!
Levioso! Levioso!
Revelio. Incendio. I wonder if I can move that platform somehow. Expelliarmus. Accio. Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this. Accio. Expelliarmus. Levioso. Another puzzle. Well, if Jackdaw could solve this, so can I. Expelliarmus. Revelio. Yeah. Protego. Revelio. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Oh.
Akio. It's a good thing Jack didn't fall down there. Revelio! Accio! Incendio! Accio! Revelio! I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. Accio! Skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this. Revelio. Accio. I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Huh?
Accio! Revelio! Accio. It is. The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. These can't be what they're headed with the Jackdaw. Expelliarmus! Levioso, Accio, Incendio. Farewell, monster. I can only imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way. Accio! Yeah. need to look around for the symbol. I thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him. I must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is, the map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Levioso!
Accio!
Levioso!
Incendio!
Expelliarmus will disarm you brutes.
Expelliarmus! Levioso!
Accio! Incendio!
Expelliarmus! Levioso! Expelliarmus! Incendio!
Accio!
Expelliarmus! Levioso!
Incendio!
Levioso!
Incendio!
Expelliarmus!
What? That's unnerving. What's happening?
Revelio.
I've seen this before. In Gringotts and the restricted section. Where am I? Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place? It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the map chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
I've always said that travel...
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with a book. Revelio.
The banishing charm, useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.